Here is Oliver, a very talented young chef who initially started with a small restaurant. With success, he expanded to create other restaurants. However, as the business grows, so does the volume of documents the company handles. As the business scales, issues in information management arise. Employees face difficulties finding the right information, lost in an unorganized mass of documents. Overall, documentation becomes less reliable due to a lack of visibility, organization, and traceability. This leads to a general decrease in organizational productivity. That's where ECM comes into play. An ECM, for enterprise content management, is a platform managing diverse content types, such as text files, PDFs, Excel files, PowerPoint presentations, but also images, records, emails, and other forms of content. ECM is crucial for a unified strategy for information governance and compliance. Examples of ECMs include Microsoft SharePoint or Alfresco, for example. The ECM facilitates the management, organization, and sharing of the entire content throughout its life cycle. Capture, which means depositing, classifying, and indexing content. Storage, by providing a centralized repository and even archiving if necessary. Processing or managing access rights, tracking modifications, different versions, and ensuring follow-up. Then, enabling users to quickly search and retrieve content using keywords, metadata, or other criteria. In summary, by providing quick, centralized, and secure access to all content, it allows increased productivity through effective documentation management and reduced document search time. Improved collaboration between teams, departments, clients, and partners. And finally, space saving and reduced physical storage and archiving costs. However, ECM is not a magic solution. A preparatory phase of needs analysis is crucial. Determining the organization's goals, needs, expectations, types of documents, volume, existing exchanges, potential ECM's options, costs, and implementation timelines. Involving future users from the beginning and throughout the implementation stages is important. A successful ECM implementation is one that adapts to the organization's functioning, not the other way around. Thank you for watching until the end of this video. If it helped and you'd like to support me, then subscribe. See you soon for the next video. Goodbye.